Miss World 1963. Yes, that's the title for which 40 girls from all over the world are competing here tonight in the Lyceum Ballroom in London. At the moment, they're backstage waiting to come out here and face our cameras and the judges. So why don't you at home make your choice from some of the loveliest girls in the world as we see them here for the first time. So here they are then competing for Miss World 1963, led by Miss Argentina.
Austria. Miss Belgium. Bolivia. Colombia. Miss Finland. Thank you. Miss Iceland. Miss Ireland. Miss Israel. Miss Jamaica. Miss Japan. Miss Jordan. Miss Korea. Liberia. Miss Luxembourg. Malaysia. Miss Mexico. Miss New Zealand. Miss Nigeria. Miss Portugal. Miss South Africa. Thank you. Miss Sweden. Venezuela.
Of the world's most beautiful girls. Now for a quick look at the judges. Carl Foreman, Soleri Constantine, the Marchioness of Tavistock, Peter Sellers, Charles Eade, John Mills, the Marchioness of Milford Haven, the Duke of Bedford, and Billy Butlin. Well, all that happened over an hour ago, and since we made that recording of the first parade, the judges have seen the girls individually in evening dress and in swimsuits. So now you've got a chance to compare your choice with that of the judges, because I think they've made their first selections. But to find out, let's join our master of ceremonies on the stage, Peter West.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. An assignment this which always makes me the envy of my men friends. And I'd like to say a very big welcome to that vast audience. I know there's an enormous audience out there which has tuned our way, and here I think I use the right phrase, anxious to study the form. In a moment or two, I hope to receive from the scrutineer the list of the 15 semi-finalists, the 15 girls who have survived from the original Grand Parade of 40 from everywhere across the world, which we've just seen, the recording at the start of our program. Our scrutineer, Charles Jacobs, has a very tough job on after our distinguished panel of judges have passed their conclusions to him. And you can imagine the tension and the excitement building up here backstage. 15 of these girls are going to come out in front. One of them is that much nearer, a wonderful first prize of £2,500 and a great deal else besides. Not only the prestige of winning a much sought-after title, £2,500, travelling round the world, literally queening it round the world, and perhaps, in fact, very likely, making herself a small fortune. During the last hour and a half, the judges have seen all the girls in swimsuits, or rather first in evening dress, and then in swimsuits. And when I have the list of the final 15, from now on we shall see them in swimsuits. How are we doing, Charles Jacobs? I know you have a very tough job on indeed. Can you imagine what it's like for the girls waiting behind. It's bad enough for me. Joe, I shall have to ask you to play some music in a moment. Let's have a little music from you while we're waiting, Joe. Can you give us some? I've never known you let us down. Over to you, Joe, just for a moment. And when I give you the signal, back to me, all right? Okay, Joe Loss. Thank you. Thank you very much, Joe. Thank you, Joe. Right now, the judges have given me a final list, in fact, of 14. And I'm going to call out the countries now in alphabetical order only, not in order of preference. And here now they come, Miss Brazil.
Ferreira, age 20, 36, 23, 36. She has black eyes and she's a surgeon's assistant.
Miss Ceylon.
Jennifer Fonseca, aged 18, 34, brown eyes. And she's a shorthand typist.
Miss Colombia.
Maria Cucalon, aged 18, 36, 23, 36, black eyes and a fashion model.
Miss Denmark.
Ino Korva, age 20, 36, 23, 36, green eyes, a model and a secretary.
Miss Finland.
Marja Lisa Stahlberg, age 19, 36, 23, 36, blue eyes, and a bank clerk.
Miss France.
Mouguet Fabry. Age 23, 35, brown eyes, a school teacher.
Miss Jamaica.
Carol Joan Crawford, age 20, 34, hazel eyes, she's a model.
Miss Korea.
Kyum Shi Choi, age 22, 35, 22, 35, black eyes, and she works in an office.
Miss Liberia.
Ethel Norman, age 23, 34, 24, 36, brown eyes, and she's a telephonist.
Miss Malaysia.
Catherine Lowe, age 19, 37, 21, 36, black eyes, a student.
Miss New Zealand.
Elaine Miskell, age 19, 36, 24, 36, hazel eyes, a fashion model.
Miss Sweden.
Greta Vibber, age 19, 35, 23, 35, greeny brownie eyes, a model.
Miss United Kingdom.
Diane Westbury, age 20, 36, 23, 36, bluey green eyes, a model.
Miss USA.
Michelle Matrinko, aged 18, 36, 24, 36, blue eyes, and she's a student.
Now the judges will want to look at the last 14 altogether, and I dare say that those of you at home will find it no hardship either. Here they are, led out once again by Miss Brazil.
Miss USA, Michelle Matrinko. Miss United Kingdom, Diane Westbury. Miss Sweden, Greta Viberg. Miss New Zealand, Elaine Miskell. Miss Malaysia, Catherine Lowe. Miss Liberia, Ethel Norman. Miss Korea, Kum Shil Choi. So we can see the other seven from the 14 coming before our cameras, and the judges, of course, like you at home, are making last-minute choices. Lining up for you, the judges, and the cameras. And here we have Miss Jamaica, Carol Joan Crawford. Miss France, Mouguette Fabry. Miss Finland, Marja Liisa Stahlberg. Miss Denmark, Ino Korva. Miss Colombia, Maria Cucalon. Miss Ceylon, Jennifer Fonseca. And lastly, Miss Brazil, Vera Ferreira.
Thank you very much, the 14 semi-finalists. Now this is the last time when we see you all in close-up as 14. Would you like to lead the way? Miss Brazil. Miss Ceylon. Miss Colombia. Miss Denmark. Finland. France. Jamaica, Korea, Liberia. Malaysia, New Zealand, Sweden, United Kingdom, USA, so that's the last time that we see 14, and now who would you select in the final set? The judges, our distinguished panel, are working on this problem here, and I dare say about 20 million other judges are working on just the same problem at home. As I was saying, they've seen them in swimsuits and evening dress. Next, they come to assess them for personality and speech. And I think now Charles Jacobs has done the trick again. And we have the list of the final seven. Thank you very much. And here they are. The last seven in Miss World 1963. Miss Denmark. Miss Finland. Miss France. Miss Jamaica. Miss New Zealand. Miss Sweden. And last of the seven in alphabetical order, Miss United Kingdom. And now, this is where the pace warms up. To help in the judgment of personality, I'm going to talk in turn to each of these girls, and you can make up your own minds at home. And first of all, I'm going to talk to Miss Denmark. Miss Denmark, a great many people are looking at you at this moment. Welcome to Great Britain. Tell us all about yourself.
My name is Aino Kova. I'll be 21 in next month. And I used to work in Copenhagen as secretary. But for the time being, I live in New York, where I work as a model.
I think also you do some television over there.
Yes, I do. I'm a hostess on a program which is called Say When. And I like it very much.
What made you want to become a beauty queen? How did you get here as Miss Denmark?
Well, actually, I didn't know anything about it myself. My fiancé submitted a picture of me for the contest, and he hoped that I was among the 8 finalists, because then he would receive some money as a prize.
He would receive some money?
Yes, he did receive the money, but I really think that he regretted very much what he was doing, because I had so much traveling to do being Miss Denmark. I was extremely happy because I loved traveling.
Did he not give you the money?
Oh, no, he didn't.
But saving it up for the marriage. Miss Denmark, we wish you both very much happiness.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Miss Finland. And Miss Finland's name is?
Maria-Lisa Stolberg, and I come from Helsinki.
Very nicely said, and I have to speak a little slowly, yes? Tell me about your work and your family.
Oh, I'm working in a bank in public relations office there, and it's very interesting, like press job. And my family, it belongs only my mother and me.
Now, Miss Finland last year was runner-up in this contest. I suppose you're hoping to do certainly as well and perhaps a little bit better.
Well, I'll try.
What is your ambition in life?
Oh, I want to be better in my peer job. That's my ambition.
Have you, like Miss Denmark, are you engaged? Have you a fiancé?
No, I'm not engaged.
Would you say, you seem to be very serious about your work, would you say that work was more important than marriage?
Marriage is important.
Thank you, Miss Finland.
Thank you.
Miss Jamaica. I beg your pardon, Miss France. Sorry. Miss France, are you going to say a little for us, un petit peu, in English?
If you speak slowly, I can...
You tell us about yourself, whatever you like to say.
My name is Muguette Fabrice, and I am a teacher of mathematics in France.
Is this your first time in London?
Yes, it's the first time I come here.
How do you like our country?
In your country, what I like, I see only London that I like.
You like London?
Yes.
What will you do if you win the money?
I don't know, but I think every time I want a shop with dresses.
A shop?
Yes.
What it's kind of shop?
For dresses.
Dress shop.
Yes.
Thank you, Miss France.
Thank you.
Miss Jamaica. Miss Jamaica, you seem to have some supporters here tonight. If I may say so, that's a very striking swimsuit. Is that the latest rage in the Caribbean?
No, it isn't. I got it in Miami.
Now, tell us about your country, Jamaica, with those lovely beaches and this hot sun. Now, come on, let's get excited about Jamaica.
We have lovely white sand beaches and beautiful mountains. And if you do come there, I'd be glad to take you around.
Oh, thank you very much. When Jamaica recently was declared independent, you played quite a big part, I believe, in the ceremonial.
That's right, I did. I attended all the functions and parties given for important people.
Now tell us about yourself.
Well, I am 20 and I help my father in his office, and now and again I model if I get the chance to.
I must ask you this, following on the West Indies cricket tour and with Sir Leary looking over my shoulder. Were you very excited when the West Indies won the last series here?
Yes, I was.
Did you meet them when they went back home
yes,
to
I
Kingston?
Did. Yes.
Who did you meet there?
Well, I met Sobers.
You, Gary Sobers?
Yes. Uh-huh. And Warrell and uh-huh. all of them. Uh-huh.
Well, there you are, Sir Leary. There's another good player here. Thank you very much, Miss Jamaica. Miss New Zealand. Miss Elaine Miskell. Welcome to Miss New Zealand. Elaine, what would you like to say to everybody?
Well, I think I'll tell them a little about where I come from and what I do. I come from Wellington in New Zealand. That's the bottom half of the North Island. I live there with my parents and younger brother, who's 15. I am a fashion model, and I'm very thrilled to be here tonight.
I've been told that you are a very good athlete.
Well, I was when I was at college, but unfortunately, I don't have very much time for that now.
You were a sprinter and a hurdler?
I was, yes.
What sort of times did you do down the 100 yards and over the hurdles?
Well, I don't really know. I don't remember the times, but I was the athletic champion of my college. But unfortunately, as things turn out, other things take the place of sport.
Well, other things for you include, I believe, singing. Is this not right, in a dance band?
Well, yes, I do.
Tell us about that.
Well, there's not very much to tell, really. I haven't got a very good voice, but, well, they seem to employ me occasionally to sing to people at home.
And have you been following the All Blacks rugby tour here?
Well, I have, but I heard, unfortunately, that they lost here.
Only once, though. They'll be delighted to meet you, I'm sure.
I'm hoping to meet them.
Thank you, Miss New Zealand.
Thank you.
Miss Sweden. Hello, Miss Sweden.
Hello.
Welcome to London.
Thank you very much.
And the microphone is all yours. What would you like to say?
I'm very nervous.
Tell us about your home. You weren't born in Sweden, were you?
No, I'm born in Oslo, but I live in Stockholm. I'm 19 years old, and I work as a model in Sweden and Paris. And I speak very bad English.
You're doing all right, yes. Don't worry. You're a dancing, I think you love that.
Oh yes, I love to dance and I love to travel. Yes, travel.
What sort of dancing do you like?
Brit, you know.
Now, the Beatles, you know the Beatles, they've
yes.
had a triumphant tour of Sweden. I believe you arrived at London Airport. They
yes.
were coming in too. Tell
yes.
us all about that.
I don't like the hairstyle the Beatles have.
Now, steady on.
Long.
Now, be careful.
I don't like it.
But they're tremendous, you know. Yeah, they're tremendous time.
Yes, I know. Many girls like it, but it's too long.
Ah, well, somebody hasn't gone bingo on Ringo. Never mind. Thank you, Miss Sweden.
Thank you.
And lastly, Miss United Kingdom. Plenty of support. For you, Diane Westbury from Ilkeston, Derbyshire. Now, a lot of folk back home in Ilkeston are looking at you now, Diane. What would you like to say to them?
I certainly hope they're all watching, as I'm so thrilled to be in the last seven. It's wonderful. Well, I'd just like to say a very good evening to you all, and my family, of course.
You're very superstitious, I believe. You're worried by the fact that you're the 13th Miss United Kingdom in the 13th Miss World contest.
Well, yes, I am. Very worried. See, I'm carrying my charm now.
You always carry it.
Yes.
Diane, you've travelled a great deal. Do you enjoy this?
I do, very much, yes.
Is this the best thing about being a beauty queen?
Well, I think it is, yes, because you get to so many places. It's wonderful.
You had a big success in the States recently.
Oh, yes, yes, that was wonderful,
well,
too.
Well, go on, tell us.
Oh, well, I was also Miss Britain this year, and I was second in the Miss International.
Diane, what about these chaperones, these interpreters? I think everybody's interested. Are they just interpreters, or are they sort of half there to guard all the girls from anything that might happen as well?
Well, I think really a bit of both, but they're very nice girls, all of them. They're wonderful. They really do help you an awful lot.
And a lot of people suspect that there's a lot of green eye and tearing of hair amongst the girls. Would you say that amongst this year's lot?
Oh, definitely not. No, they're wonderful girls.
Well, there you are. I couldn't say fairer than that. Thank you very much, Miss United Kingdom. Well, it's not long before we know now, and we're going to have just one final look, and the judges here will have one final look at these girls for deportment, led off by Miss Denmark. Miss Finland. In alphabetical order, United Kingdom. Now, for the very last time, they line up together in front of the judges, and I think quite briefly, would you lead on, please, the final seven. you choose. Miss Denmark. Miss Finland. Miss France. Miss Jamaica. Miss New Zealand. Miss Sweden. And Miss United Kingdom. One of them very soon now, as they lead to the dais. Thank you, Miss United Kingdom. It's so close to £2,500. Waiting to hand on the crown to her successor, Catharina Lodders of Holland, Miss World 1962. We are ready now for the results. First, I want you all to meet the man who will present the awards tonight, the joint chairman of Mecca Limited, Mr. Alan B. Fairley. And I would like to add at this point that the entire proceeds of the Miss World contest go to the Variety Club of Great Britain. Their chief barker, Mr. Rex North, is in the audience tonight. And in due course, he is going to receive a most handsome check for distribution to children's charities. Right, it's time for the results. To announce them, the organizing director of this contest, Mr. Eric Morley.
The results of Miss World 1963 in reverse order, just handed to me by the scrutineers. Fifth position, Miss Sweden.
And Miss Sweden gets £100 and the silver trophy.
Fourth, Miss Denmark.
And Miss Denmark gets £150 and the trophy.
Third, Miss Finland.
For Miss Finland, there's £250 and the silver trophy.
The runner-up to Miss World, Miss New Zealand.
And Miss New Zealand gets £500 and the silver trophy.
And now, a young lady who receives a check for £2,500, a screen test by Columbia Pictures, Miss World 1963, Miss Jamaica. Now, Last year's Miss World hands over the crown to her successor. Mr. Alan Fairley presents the trophy. She is now handed her scepter. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let us salute Miss World 1963.